Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept that is the bad debt reserves or the allowance of the bad debt expenses. Let's try and understand in the detailed format. As you can see over here, detail of the Shuttershock.inc is a consolidated financial statement, and we have the detail of the cash flow statement from the operating activities. There we have the data of the bad debt reserve as 1292, 2992 and 3175 or 6 it is for 2017, 16 and 15 respectively. This was just to show how or where exactly bad debt reserve has been recorded. It is also the part of the profit and loss account where it is deducted from the bad debt, and including in the data also it is taken into account. Now let's understand what exactly bad debt reserve is all about. See, bad debt reserve is an account which offsets or reduces the account receivable, that is your debtors, in the books of accounts. So the thumb rule of the business in generating profit, so keeping non-profit organization aside, which works for the betterment of the society, all other organization works towards the earning of profit, you can say that they earn for profit by means of increasing the revenue. So we all know that revenues earned by the organization is not settled by the cash at the time of delivery of goods or competition of service. So there is a time lag in between, which we refer to as credit period. Example, like, you know, the great and company, let's say, is involved in the business of manufacturing heavy machinery, which generally costs machinery that costs closely to more than 1 lakh per piece, and in this case the payment terms defined as per the company policy were something like this. You know, the advance was 10% on the acceptance of the order, second the release of the 30% of the payment on completion, and 50% of the work order after the certification of the completion. There was also a release of 30% of the payment on delivery of the machinery to the at the customer's warehouse. Another clause that release of the full and final payment within closely to 30 days after the delivery. So you must have noticed, you know, the payment terms in the above case are a bit complex. Now let's take another example, letting us take an example of small end company which is involved in the business of supplying leather accessories. The credit policy of the company is that, you know, all the payment is due within, let's say, 45 days of the delivery of the goods of the customers. Now, as opposed to the great end company that we discussed here, small company has very simple payment terms. No matter how simpler or complex the credit policy or payment terms a company has, they are bound to some credit risk that is involved. So, credit risk is nothing but the fact that the customer might not end up paying the amount when it is due. So there are two thoughts about the fact that this would lead to loss to the company. So to account for the loss, the company maintains a provision in its books of accounts which are known as the bad debt reserves account. Right, so why is this bad debt reserve account is required? See, accounting has its own rules and principles, right, which needs to be adhered to while maintaining and updating the books of accounts. The basic governing accounting principle, that is the conservatism principle of accounting, which indicates that, you know, any losses that should be accounted for at the earliest, while the profit should be accounted for only after the sufficient proof of that particular thing is available, or is available that the profit will be accrued in the near future. So since there is always a possibility of debt turning into bad and the customers not paying the complete amount, we tend to maintain a reserve in the books of accounts for the future event, which we called as the bad debt reserve. Now you must have got a clear idea regarding bad debt reserve. Let's take an example so as to understand this in a more detailed and crystal clear format. So to understand how bad debt reserve works, let's first see the basic entry which we pass for the accounting a credit sale transaction in the books of accounts. Let's say there's a company called KG Inc. which has received an order for, let's say, for 500 leather wallets. Leather wallets is what they have got the order for. The selling price for the product is, let's say, $10 each. And it has successfully delivered this goods at the customer's warehouse as per the pre-approval terms of trade. So the risk of the inventory has passed on to the customer when the customer has accepted the delivery of the goods. And at this point of time, we'll pass in journal entry something like this. The account receivable account that will be debited, which will be closely to 5,000, to the sales account that will be 5,000. So, as we can see that, you know, the account receivable will always show a debit balance in the books of, whereas, you know, the sales being the revenue will be transferred to the profit and loss account, right? So, in that scenario, what we can do that, you know, now as for the purpose of the bad debt reserve is to offset the account receivable. It has a credit balance, right? And the entry for the same will go something like this, like, you know, the bad debt account or the bad debt expense account will be debited. That will be 50, and to bad debt reserve, which will have a credit entry to the extent of 50. So the bad debt reserve account will reduce the account receivable over here by $50, and the net account receivable to be presented in the books of accounts will be at 4950, 5000 less 50, right, in the balance sheet of the companies, in the company. Now, let's understand the bad debt reserve accounting. See, as you must have noticed, you know, there are two different accounts that have been used to give the debit effect for the above bad debt reserve journal entry. This is because, you know, there are two ways to account for bad debt expense. One is the direct bad debt written off method. Now, this particular method is used when the organization can pinpoint invoice for which the payment is not going to be received. So this method invokes you can say that this method involves writing off the revenues itself, and is possible when there is one-to-one correlation. This is a very important point for this particular method. A one-to-one correlation between them, between the sales and the debt turning bad. So this is an aggressive method, quite aggressive one. And in the case, the entire invoice is reversed, which also leads to the reversal of the taxes and the other statutory dues booked along the invoice side. Second, which is known as the provision method. Now, this is the less aggressive method to account for the bad debt reserve. In this case, you know, a provision is created for the bad debt expenses, which can be written off in the next accounting period. And again, a fresh provision is created. So most organizations prefer to go ahead with this particular method. And this method goes hand in hand with the matching concept. You can say matching concept and the accrual accounting of a system. Okay, matching concept is basically the revenue that has been booked in the given period of time and should be matched with the expenses incurred towards earning that revenue, which basically means that the expenses should also be recognized in the same period in which the revenue has been recognized. So by using the provision method, you can recognize the bad debt allowance in the period in which the revenue is booked. Now, the above advantage of the provision method is the disadvantage of the direct bad debt written off method. So there will be always be a time lag when the revenue is booked and the company is sure that the amount will not be receivable. So this does not go well with the matching concept of the accounting, and so it's therefore not accepted by the accounting standard as well. So, there are a couple of methods that you can, the techniques to estimate the bad debt allowances. The first method is by, you know, you can go for the historical method. The second method people takes into account is the Pareto analysis, a very fantastic way of analyzing things in any business. Okay, so these were the two methods that can be used in the course. And there are a couple of things that, you know, bad debt reserve are used to basically manipulate the books of accounts. See, bad debt reserve are like, you know, is a good technique which can be used to decrease the net taxable profit of the company, which will help actually to reduce the tax expense. And therefore, you know, there is a strict rules which will prevent the companies to take benefit of the bad debt reserve for tax saving purpose. This is it for the bad debt reserve.
If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.